of a throwback Thursday with this one. It was the US sitcom that coined the phrase
dyno-mite.
Talking about the controversial show Goodtimes, and Richard Reed caught up with two of its stars.
Could have imagined that a show set in the poverty-stricken projects of Chicago would be filled with so many good times. James, his wife Florida, and their three sassy kids all cracking jokes in the ghetto.
Ma, we won't get no police in this neighborhood.
Oh, yes, we will. You tell them we white.
Get up off of that thing!
And thanks to the amazing Hollywood show that reunites stars of yesteryear with their fans, I got the chance to catch up with two of its stars. Putting a poor black family on primetime TV was a gamble.
That's me!
And one that its stars Jimmy Walker and John Amos weren't convinced would pay off.
TV wasn't what it was now, you know, in terms of being a comic. Our whole hook was getting on the Johnny Carson show.
Here's Johnny!
I was looking for as much opportunity for laughter, chuckles, ha-has as possible.
To put us in the mood for what I'm about to say,
and you know, you made it very difficult at those times when I'm supposed to be seriously angry, and I'd be standing next to him. He'd whisper something under his breath, crack me up, water's running out of my eyes. I'm trying to act like tears of compassion and trying to keep from laughing.
How do I love thee? Let me count the ways. I love you for your skin's pure sheen, for your two sweet lips with teeth in between.
The series was designed to be a launching pad for Amos and actress Esther Rolle.
Let me get you some coffee.
No, I ain't got time, but I'll take the sugar.
But it was the character of JJ who became the breakout star with his infectious catchphrase.
I'm dynamite! Dynamite! Dynamite!
After you came out and you had the line dynamite,
right.
It was everywhere,
yes.
And it was on shirts, it
right.
was on hats, everyone was saying it.
Right.
Do you feel like that kind of took over? Do you feel like that you own that?
Yeah, I mean, it did take over, there's no doubt about it, because when we do a show and we'd have some little rhyme or something that will build up to it, my friend TK Carter was on the show and he would write some little hippity hop and a dinkity bop, and you could feel the crowd,
dynamite!
And you two played father and son on the show. Did you have a father and son relationship in real life?
No.
No?
We're actors. We're actors. Jimmy's a comedian. We were going for laughs. He was a comedic foil on the show. And I was a stern, but hopefully fair father.
Look in my heart and let love.
While the show was big on laughs, it didn't shy away from the serious issues of trying to survive ghetto life.
It was an opportunity to show the world, and particularly the American public, what life is like in a black family in the projects that are economically challenged. You know, we still had principles, we still had ethics, we still had moral values that we wanted to uphold. It was a challenge, but we got through it, and it worked out all right.
Turn on the stereo.
The stereo.
Yeah. Give me a little exit music. I mean, make things sound normal around here.
But it was the lack of serious storylines that led to serious problems on the set. And after 3 years, Amos clashed with network executives about JJ's over-the-top shenanigans and was abruptly fired and killed off the show.
We regret to inform you that your husband, James Evans, was killed in an automobile.
To save the show, producers brought in a 10-year-old Janet Jackson to try and sass things up.
So long, suckers.
After the last airing in 1979, both John and Jimmy went on to have successful careers. Jimmy returned to stand-up on the comedy circuit.
The Maury Povich Who Your Daddy Baby Show!
And John looking after Bruce Willis in Die Hard.
You can't talk to me like that.
Well, no, Carmine.
Sergeant, get this bureaucrat out of Mr. McClane's face, now.
With pleasure, sir.
And while the two may have had their differences in the past, these days, all they can remember are the good times.
Bit of a stroll down memory lane, wasn't it?
Oh, it was amazing.
So
show.
Good to see you again. I love that show.
It was fantastic.
Good show.
And how Totally TV was their solution when the two main leads had a fight? Said, oh no, we'll just kill off the old guy and bring in a 10-year-old girl. So it's great. You can just see a budgie, 10 white guys with ponytails sitting around the boardroom going, yeah, that'll work.